There was once a very young boy who lived alone with his mother in the farthest northwest coast of Ireland. And this young boy loved nothing so much as to wander along the sands after a storm to find out what the ocean had cast up, because he used to find treasures. But one morning, after a tremendous great storm, he wandered along the strand, and what did he find washed up on the shore? But of all things, he found a harp. Well, he'd never seen one before, but he picked it up and he put it under his arm, and he continued his wanderings along the sands. But in the course of his rambles, his fingers strayed against the strings, and the sound that came out was to him so enchanting that he ran right back to his mother's cottage to show her what he'd found. And all throughout that day, he plucked on the strings, and the sound that came out was marvelous. But he soon found that he couldn't shape that sound into music. And as day followed day, and he plucked on the strings, he became more and more depressed, because he found that he had a great, deep love of music in his heart, but he hadn't any skill for it in his fingers. And so he slept very little, he ate very poorly, and his mother, who was very wise and beautiful and young, understood her son's pain, but she could give him no comfort. And so she went down the way to the druid man under the oak tree, and she said, "Please, please, either give my son the gift of music, or for God's sake," she said, "would you take away from him this desire to play music?" And the druid replied, "What'll you give me if I do the one thing or the other?" "I'll give you whatever you ask of me." "Well, give me your soul, and I'll give him the gift of music. Give me your body, and I'll take away from him this desire to play music, who it seems to me like a simple choice. Take my soul," she said, "for I would have my son a great musician." And so from that day out, the bargain was struck, and the son became the greatest harp player in Ireland. But the mother, when she died, had to give up her soul and go away down to the other world, where they say that to this very day, she sings a song called the Bron Omna, or the Soul Agony. And the old people say that in the course of this young man's life, during the daytime, he would play music of such gladness that he could charm the eagle from the wren, the hawk from the dove, and the fox from the lamb. But they also say that at night he could hear the soul agony of his mother, and it would tear at his heart. And they say that you could hear her singing in the music that he played.